installment of trading card unboxing. So this time I've chosen 10 packs of cards. So first, an overview. We're going to begin with these classic toy cards, followed by Chopper Chicks of Mars. Monsters, rock and roll, outer space, action figures, etc. Let's see what's inside. Alright, it seems that they all have very stark white backgrounds. Alright, first we have Shirley Temple. About the toy and the current monetary value. And this is in the early 90s. So if you have any of these items hanging around, you can type in the 90s value and adjust for inflation. Okay, Have Gun Will Travel. Looks like a board game. And it looks fun. If I ever come across a copy, to bring it to game night. So here's a fast and fun game. What do you think the value of this would be in $1993? I'm going to guess maybe 100. Hey, what? What? Okay, you saw me unbox this, and there's no way I could have known. What a guess. I must just be tuned into board gaming, since one of my hobbies and major social is board games. Alright, so now I'm going to fail miserably at trying to guess the value of this awesome Lost in Space game. I am far more interested in outer space themes than Western themes, although Cult Express is a good modern Western themed game. Alright, so the value I'm going to guess, it looks like it's maybe from a few years later than the Have Gun Will Travel game. I'm going to say a value of $75. What? What? Okay, alright. Dear viewers, I promise you that I have never, ever looked at these cards before. Never. Wow. Alright, I'm stunned. This is not a board game. I feel a lot less tension about guessing, so I'm going to guess anyway and say, I don't know, maybe $65, $250. Okay, I was way low. Next, the Monsters card game, which looks like great fun. Once again, I'm just going to throw out a value of $75, and this one's only $25. I've really lost my touch, haven't I? But I like some of these quite a lot. They're going to make their way into my collection. All right, we have Beetle This looks like kind of a bobblehead. Let's see, which beetle is that? Looks like he's playing a five-stringed guitar. just because of the plastic model not having six strings, but it's, I suppose that's a John Lennon. And it's Beatles memorabilia, so I'm going to say $300. And finally, the Twiggy game. Alright. Let's just guess $100. Nope, $60. Alright, well, you were there along with me for the ride when I miraculously guessed the value of two of those. So thanks for being here. Alright, next, Chopper Chicks of Mars. Okay. Not too certain about this IP. But it seems interesting enough. And a unique choice in the packaging, just a little touch of tape. Well, once again, rather stark card backings. And we have character here, very scantily clad. Seems that all of these women are going to be wearing very little. She was a little old lady who was transformed into a chopper chick. This is kind of cool. It looks like a motorcycle slash like rocket ship. Alright, I'm going to have to check these off camera to make sure none of them are inappropriate, but I don't think any of them are going to be. This is, in fact, a better look at this awesome motorcycle. It's got to be the same thing. I sold my motorcycle last year. So, but if I had one of these rocket motorcycles that travels through space and time, I definitely would not have sold it. All right, looks like an Easter Island style. Like structure built into the rock. Martian tomb, it says. Okay, and then we have this character named Kathy. And this must be one of their enemies, kind of like a Krang situation going on here. And the monster's name is the Giant Brain of Mars. A seer. Psychic Hotline, so there's a unique humor, and I suppose this was a comic, unfortunately never made into like TV or anything, and that's Jennifer, and a similar looking Martian biker babe. This is a slave girl with her pet. Alright, so with the passing of Princess Leia, this is appropriate. It says women took over the planet Mars. Alright, so there she is with her own Jabba the Hutt. Alright, interesting. Now, I can rarely resist these Rob Rebell cards. This series has gone on for a really long time, and some of my early favorites are still available at the flea market where I buy these cards, and usually I'll get a pack or two for these showings, and just for some reason it seems like this artist never really disappointed too much, but I'm going to hope right now for not too many doubles. Right, and of course the first one we encounter is a double, but an awesome striking card. Very evocative image. I'll probably use that very phrase in the past. Okay, I also like this one quite a lot. It's very successful to use this limited color palette. Alright, hard to pin down. I can really not even tell what's going on here. Birdman. You have to use the intellectual and the emotional, it says. And flipping it around like this, I believe that this is the beak and the eye. So, but without that helpful hint from the back, card backing, I don't think I ever would have figured it out. Alright, we have this beast bursting into the window. I suppose I'm going to have to stop buying Rob Rebel card sets, because most of these, at least fully half of those, I think are double. Alright, here we have, this could be a biker from Mars card, if they were drawn in a more realistic style. And if this one says something about being a slave girl on the back, I wouldn't be surprised. Star Wars really, influenced a lot of artists and the imaginations of creative types all around the world. And another double. This crazy beastie. Nightmarish. Thanks for sticking with me if you've been watching this series from the beginning. And you've seen all this before. What? A double in the very same card set. That's kind of rare. But a nice card. Oh, this one's really nice. Not seen this one before. Yeah, it's beautiful. You can really unfold the metaphor there. I'll leave you to that as we examine this like vampiric creature. That's a wonderful shot. Okay. Now, moving into the realm of the real. Some would say some WCW cards. And I think this company emerged as a competitor with WWF. And when I was very young, I would go and watch WWF performances. And one time I saw Jake the Snake doing battle with the Macho Man, Randy Savage, in real life in a steel cage match. And it was awesome. My grandmother and my mom alike would take me to these shows, or I'm not really sure if I went. I suppose I went like twice, once with my mom and once with my granny. Okay, I'm not going to know any of these wrestlers, though, I don't think. But I do like cards that give you all the info about the person on the back. It says these are some bad dudes. Also, when I was in college, I had only been in college for a year or two, so I was probably maybe like 19 or 20. And one of my roommates had a brother who won some free tickets to a wrestling performance, and I went also with him to enjoy the atmosphere. And I watched. I don't remember anything about that except for face paint and the pink jumper. I'm not sure what the article of clothing is called. Alright, Terry Taylor. Maybe we have some info about him. Alright, the fabulous Freebirds. Also the name of a board game publication company. Z-Man Games. I can't name any of their games, though. At the moment, off the top of my head, another Lex Luger card. And finally, we have the Steiner Brothers, which also somehow seems kind of familiar to me. All right. Somehow related to the Merlin collection. This seems really intriguing to me. It didn't mention that it's a booster pack of any kind, but I didn't look closely. But it has scratch and slay rules, so kind of a play on scratch and sniff. And these, I suppose, must be the rules to the game. So I'm gonna hang on to this for just a minute. And we will get a look at one of these cards. Okay, already this is very unique. Alright, so, wow. Okay, very, very interesting. This is very cool. We have life counters here. Are indicating that it's the head and the arm and the leg. And these also are listed as legs and heads and arms. And an awesome piece of artwork there in the middle. And lots of story information. Very cool. This came out in 1993. Battle cards. So it seems that you would be choosing to scratch off one of these. And red wound symbols would be a hit. And if it's blank, your opponent takes a turn. And then you can cause wounds and skull symbols and everything, and you can defeat the monster. And then you discover under the purse card how much gold you got. So, wow, that's very, very, very neat. I'm going to hang on to that and probably play this game with a friend. The Bone Scratcher. Very novel and very interesting. Like this when I was a kid. So it seems that they all say arm and leg and body and head and life points and a purse. So like a zombie creature there. And now we have the Trading Post, which is a completely unique card type. It doesn't look like it's a battle at all. Maybe you're getting equipment or something. So very, very neat. Okay, you can only scratch off boxes, and they're telling you to send this card in, and something's going to be sent to you. Wow. And the Secrets card. I think this is also an opponent or someone you would do battle with. So I suppose, yeah, and here's some clues about the alphabet that we noticed on the back of this first card. Alright, so this is really neat. Like, if I, had a pocket full of these cards, and, one of my friends did too, we could do battle. Very neat. Alright. We'll call her Titania. A fierce beast with a thirst for blood. Awesome. The decayer is a really, really dark theme here. Probably too dark for some. The venomous pouring wine or a ritual concoction into an upturned skull. So it looks like some creature's put a drink from it and some other strange creatures are about. An enigmatic serpentine alchemist. Alright, so this is very unique and probably one of the coolest things I've ever unboxed on this series. The Amulet of Eternal Beauty. Which will certainly make its way into my collection. Awesome. I've opened a number of these, so I'm just hoping for another NWA card, or maybe maybe if we're lucky, we'll get another well, now I'm seeing all the names here, it's distracting me. Too short. Dream, Grandmaster Flash, Sir Mix-a-Lot. All right, let's just dive in. I can't wait any longer. I think I got a Gangstar card out of one of these sets in the past. So it's really neat that there's like one each of these graffiti cards in each one of these Rat Pack sets. Slamming Sounds giveaway. Alright, the Candyman. Rapper. Ain't No Shame in My Game. Was one of his albums. The Next School. Nice looking card. Get in Play. Alright. Also famous on TV or movies. They had a lot of fame back in the 90s. All right, Kid Rock. Okay, to compare, let's move Kid and Play back into the frame. And I don't know, it's almost a toss up. Which one has the biggest hair? A centimeter. Or wait, which one's Kid? Okay. Kid, not Kid Rock. Alright, so long before his rap rock days and his rise to superstardom in the mid-90s. Okay, the Kings of Swing. Interesting. Lounging a bit. Audio 2. Alright, I'm definitely going to keep this card. Very stylish duo. Too Short, yes. Alright. After opening several of these packs and not getting it Too Short, this is a real treat. And, Too Short is still rapping. Probably up to like 30 albums so far. Keeping his beat slow and full of funky bass. Alright. This card is just all about cold chilling. And I love it. Love it, love it. Very much. Bismarck Key was on this label. You got what I need. This is nice. I think it's Betty and Wilma. Is that right? Betty Rubble and Wilma Flintstone. Fred and Barney. Yeah. Nice looking cards there at the drive-in movie, looking at the card face portion of it. So nicely done. A good presentation here. And I like that card. Sushi. Wowza. Auto turtle assembly line. That's incredible. What fun. Alright, and we still have three more packs to enjoy together. Uncle Sam's home defense. To know the horrors of war is to want peace. Has not exploded, so they're trying to remove it from the scene. Yeah, this is really depicting the horrors of war. The bomb squad, yeah. Often known as suicide squads. Removal of delayed action time bombs. Actually, once I was, I believe, on Martha's Vineyard. Posted on the beach, and it was giving you a warning that if you found a bomb or some type of explosive device, it told you how to identify it and to stay away, basically. Alright, so we have a picture of peace, and then the contrasting image of wartime. Messengers in the army. Okay. And the soldiers, I believe, warning this family that some danger is brewing. And then we have searchlights and other unsettling things going on in the background. Lighting supervision. He's telling everyone to turn all their lights off if there's any light at all. city. Yeah. Fire core and oh wow. I didn't think I would ever see a garden quite like this. Cheers when the executioner destroys his victim with one shot and makes fun of him if he misses. Note the tightly pulled ropes attached to the bound hands of each prisoner. No chance of one of these scoundrels getting away once he is caught. Our picture shows a firing squad busy at its task of wiping out a group of disloyal Chinese discovered accepting Japanese gold in the vicinity of Hankou. Some Dungeons and Dragons cards. Beautiful looking foil pack. Okay, there we can get a look at some of the personalities. Fantasy cards. Quick to let you know that they're counterfeit proof. Me that they're going to be releasing a new code. Jason Momoa. I'm not sure if that's the way you pronounce his name, but he was in Game of Thrones as Khal Drogo, played Conan, but now they're going to have Schwarzenegger back, and he's going to be reprising his role and playing Conan as a king 30 years after his ascending to the throne. Alright, Tessa. Of fighters without any strategy. And the Bone Snapper. And the Beast Man. And the Titanothere. Okay, interesting. Alright, let's round down today's showing with this Nintendo Game Pack. Scratch-off cards and two stickers. You know, I've been thinking that I need to put stickers on my wheelbarrow, which I use for work all the time, and it's just sorely lacking stickers. Alright, so here we have one. This is Little Mac taking on King Hippo. Pretty awesome. It's going to tell us on the back. Some info, top secret tips. This is an awesome sticker. Yes. And we have a tip for Double Dragon. Okay. And this said this were a scratch off card, so. And